morning. Welcome all of you today in the name of our Lord. A special welcome to any guests we have with us today and those joining us on the live stream to this second Sunday after the Epiphany. A couple of quick announcements. First of all, this morning we will have a forum on our worship and ministry plan for 2020. So that'll happen in the patio room. If you want to grab coffee and donuts and head in there, you can take part in that conversation. Next weekend, we will have three important events. Four, at 9:45, there's going to be an information meeting on the Honduran trip for those who would like to find out more about that. That'll happen in the fireside room. And then in the patio room, we'll continue with our study on worship, why worship matters. After that, at noon, we'll have our congregational meeting, elect officers, adopt our ministry plan for 2020. And then, that evening is a concert series with Michael Day. So you full day next weekend, and please join us for any and all of those opportunities. We begin today with a thanksgiving for baptism at the font, so please stand.
Holy God, holy and merciful, holy and mighty, you are the river of all life. Glory to you for oceans and lakes, for rivers and streams, for clouds and rain, for dew and snow. Your waters are below us, around us, above us. Our life is born in you. Praise to you, our saving waters. Noah and the animals survived the flood. Hagar discovers your well. The Israelites escape through the sea, and they drink from your gushing rock. Naaman washes his leprosy away, and the Samaritan woman will never be thirsty again. At this font, holy God, we pray. Praise to you for the water of baptism and for your word that saves us in this water. Breathe your spirit into all who are gathered here and into all creation. Illumine our days, enliven our bones, dry our tears, wash away the sin within us, and drown the evil around us. Satisfy all our thirst with your living water through Jesus Christ, now and forever. Amen. Amen.
I want to walk as a child of the light. I want to follow Jesus. Set the start.
Jesus.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray. Holy God, our strength and our Redeemer, by your Spirit hold us forever, that through your grace we may worship you and faithfully serve you, follow you, and joyfully find you through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Please be seated. Do we have some younger people who would come forward at this time and sit with me, and we will talk together. We will talk about many things. Hello.
Hello.
Good morning. How are you?
Good.
Is it early? It's a little early, isn't it? But that's okay. Hey, come on up. Come on over this way. Hi. Come up. Good morning. How are you doing?
Good.
Good. I want to talk to you about somebody that you know. Who do you think I want to talk to you about?
Jesus.
I always like to talk to you about Jesus, but this is actually somebody else that you know that I'd like to talk to. You know who it is?
No.
Bet you won't guess. Well, I want to talk to you about your friends, about people that you know and you like at school. Do you have some friends at school or maybe at someplace else? Does anybody want to tell me about their friend, like their best friend or a couple of their really good friends? Do you have a couple of good friends?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? So who's one of the friends? Just first names, please.
Madison.
Madison. And so why is she a good friend?
She lives really close to me.
She lives close to you. Oh, so you guys hang out together and have a lot, yeah, that you do together. Anybody else have a friend you want to tell me about? Somebody, you have friends at school though, right? So I think about Madison and I think about our friends. And today Jesus talks about having people that he wants to connect with and then have those people connect with other people. And part of that is kind of what you do with your friends. And the point for Jesus is that as we talk to our friends, that we guess what? What do you think Jesus wants us to do with our friends? Any idea? You'll find out today in the sermon that Jesus wants to invite our friends. Guess where Jesus wants us to invite our friends to? You'll never guess. Here. Jesus wants to invite our friends here. Have you ever invited your friend to church? No? What do you think? Do you like it here at church? It's okay. When we're having fun, it's especially good, right? Yeah. So, what we could do, though, is invite our friends. If this is a place that you like, which I hope it is, but you would invite your friends here. And maybe we would have more friends here and we'd have a little more fun. They don't have to come every week. If they want to, that's great. But maybe even one time. That's a way that we show others that we care and we think about them when we invite them into our family here at church. So that's a way that we remind our friends how much we care about them. And it's a way for us to meet your friends and talk to them a little bit about Jesus if they'll listen. How's that sound? Yeah, but it's hard to invite people, isn't it? So, practice with me here. Say, hello, friend.
Hello.
It's good for you too. Hello, friend. I would like you to come with me to church sometime, maybe next week. How's that sound? And we'll see. We'll see. Yeah. And then we'll see. We'll see what happens, okay? That'd be great, because I'd like to meet your friends, and we'd like to have them here too, okay? So let's have a prayer. We're going to pray for our friends. Say, dear God, thank you for today and our friends. We ask, God, that you help us be brave and ask our friends to come to church. And if they ask, that we would go to their church too. In Jesus' name, we pray and play and invite. Amen. All right. Thank you, guys.
Good morning. The first lesson this morning is a reading from Isaiah. Listen to me, O coastlands. Pay attention, you peoples from far away. The Lord called me before I was born. While I was in my mother's womb, he named me. He made my mouth like a sharp sword. In the shadow of his hand, he hid me. He made me a polished arrow. In his quiver, he hid me away. And he said to me, you are my servant, Israel, in whom I will be glorified. But I said, I have labored in vain. I have spent my strength for nothing and vanity. Yet surely my cause is with the Lord, and my reward with my God. And now the Lord says, who formed me in the womb to be his servant, to bring Jacob back to him, and that Israel might be gathered to him. For I am honored in the sight of the Lord, and my God has become my strength. He says, it is too light a thing that you should be my servant to raise up the tribes of Jacob and to restore the survivors of Israel. I will give you as a light to the nations, that my salvation may reach to the end of the earth. Thus says the Lord, the Redeemer of Israel and his Holy One, to one deeply despised, abhorred by the nations, the slaves of rulers. Kings shall see and stand up, princes, and they shall prostrate themselves because of the Lord, who is faithful, the Holy One of Israel, who has chosen you. The word of God for the people of God.
Thank you.
second reading is a reading from Corinthians. Paul, called to be an apostle of Christ Jesus by the will of God, and our brother Sosthenes, to the church of God that is in Corinth, to those who are sanctified in Christ Jesus, called to be saints, together with all those who in every place call on the name of Lord Jesus Christ, both their Lord and ours. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. I give thanks to my God always for you, because of the grace of God that has been given you in Christ Jesus. For in every way you have been enriched in him, in speech and knowledge of every kind, just as the testimony of Christ has been strengthened among you, so that you are not lacking in any spiritual gift as you wait for the revealing of our Lord Jesus Christ. He will also strengthen you to the end, so that you will be blameless on the day of our Lord Jesus Christ. God is faithful. By him you are called into the fellowship of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. The word of God for the people of God.
The Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
John the Baptist saw Jesus coming toward him and declared, "Here is the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. This is he of whom I said, 'After me comes a man who ranks ahead of me because he was before me.' I myself did not know him, but I came baptizing with water for this reason, that he might be revealed to Israel." And John testified, "I saw the Spirit descending from heaven like a dove, and it remained on him. I myself did not know him, but the one who sent me to baptize with water said to me, 'He on whom you see the Spirit descend and remain is the one who baptizes with the Holy Spirit.' And I myself have seen and have testified that this is the Son of God." The next day, John again was standing with two of his disciples, and as he watched Jesus walk by, he exclaimed, "Look, here is the Lamb of God." The two disciples heard him say this, and they followed Jesus. When Jesus turned and saw them following, he said to them, "What are you looking for?" And they said to him, "Rabbi," which translates means teacher, "where are you staying?" He said to them, "Come and see." They came and saw where he was staying, and they remained with him that day. It was about 4 o'clock in the afternoon. One of the two who heard John speak and followed him was Andrew, Simon Peter's brother. He first found his brother Simon and said to him, "We have found the Messiah," which is translated anointed. He brought Simon to Jesus, who looked at him and said, "You are Simon, son of John. You are to be called Cephas," which is translated Peter. The Gospel of the Lord. Be seated. Grace, mercy, and peace be to you from God our Father and our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Well, I just want to warn you, today is a very scary topic. It brings fear to us to even think about it. No, it's not cancer or heart disease. It's not climate change. It's not even the possibility of war in the Middle East. It's something that frightens all of us to our very core, especially as Lutherans. It's called evangelism. Now, evangelism is a scary word for us because, one hand, we think about people who come knocking on doors and asking us when we've been saved, or do you know if you're going to heaven, or do you believe in Jesus, and how do you know you believe in Jesus, or even if you don't believe in Jesus, you're in danger of going to hell. So our immediate sense of revulsion at this idea of evangelism is we don't want to be like them. The other reason that evangelism is so problematic for us is we've come to believe in our country that faith and things about religion are private. It's not the kind of thing nice people talk about at parties. And so today I'd like to help us explain and examine evangelism in a different way, in the way that John portrays it in this gospel. And it really is portrayed having three parts. One is to notice. The second is to share. And the third is to invite. Now you'll recognize that the first thing that John does in this gospel is to notice God's activity. In fact, that's what epiphany means, God made known, God revealed. And he notices that it is Jesus who has been sent by God to bring about God's work in the world and to do God's ministry among people. So, one of the things that we need to start with if we are even going to think about entering into this work of evangelism is, do you notice God at work? Do you notice God's activity in your daily life? Do you notice God's activity in the world as we look at it? Where is God doing stuff among us and for us? Do we even notice that God is at work in the world? And maybe if we don't, it's the kind of the beginning place to start. Noticing what God is up to. Recognizing that it's not just fate or luck, but that God's really active, that God really is at work. And maybe if we, in the immediate sense, don't notice God at work, maybe we could ask a different question, and that is, where do we wish to see God at work in our lives and in our world? Where do we hope to see that God is active and doing God's work among us through Jesus? Now, the second thing that John points to is that if we're going to be evangelists, we have to be able to share our experience of God. That we have to be able to talk about what it is that makes God important to us. And maybe the easiest way for us to start that conversation is by asking ourselves, why is it that we come here? Why is it that we participate in this community of faith? Why is it that we happen to be part of our Savior's Lutheran Church, and what's important about that for our lives? Why does it bring us joy and happiness to be here and in part of this community? So I'm going to give you a little chance to practice that. We're going to take a couple of minutes, turn to somebody in front of you, behind you, next to you, and for just a couple of minutes, share with another person what it is that brings you joy, what is it that brings you here, what is it that you find so important about being part of this community of faith. And for those of you who are live streaming, you can use your comment card tab to just make those comments online. So just take a couple of minutes, turn to somebody near you, in front of you, behind you. What is it about this congregation, this community of faith, our worship that gives you joy and that makes a difference for you? Okay, I hope that you maybe discovered some new things about yourself and about other people around you that bring you joy and excitement and that are positive about your experience here at Our Savior's and as part of this Christian community. Now, why not take that story? Why not share those things that excite you, that makes you feel so great about this community of faith, and tell somebody else about it? I mean, we really are good at inviting people to stuff, right? I mean, we invite people to a new restaurant that we found that we really liked, and we hope that they might try that place out too. Or we invite people over for dinner or to go out for dinner together. Or, you know, we invite people over to play cards or other kind of board games or just to have an evening of coffee and conversation. So we know how to invite people. We're good at that. So we just need to take that another step and begin to invite others to be part of, and at least to try out, our community of faith. At least to check it out. Come and see, Jesus says. Come and see. We don't need to have the answers. We don't even have to have the right questions. All we have to do is to share from our own experience why this place makes a difference and may make a difference for you too. Come and see. So evangelism really need not be scary, for it really does just come down to those three things: noticing how God is at work in our lives and in our world and in our church and through us, and then being able to share in a very positive, low-key way how that makes a difference. And then inviting people to be part of that, to experience that, to see what it's like. Why would we want to not let other people know about what gives us so much joy and hope and a place to belong? So it need not be fearful. And it is what's going to take our inviting to make a difference to a world that really needs that invitation to come and have Christ seek us out and make Christ known to us through his word and sacrament as he does today. Amen.
By the Lord of sea and sky,
gathered as sisters and brothers in Christ, let us affirm our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Called together through water and the word, we boldly pray for the church, the world, and all who long to hear God's voice. Faithful God, we thank you for the testimony of disciples throughout the generations and for opportunities to proclaim your mercy. Reveal your truth and glory to all who ponder your word of life. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Creating God, we marvel at the abundance of the world you have made. Give us confidence in our calling to be stewards of the earth so that our lives are in fellowship with all creation. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Almighty God, we are thankful for all who have marched for justice and advocated for peace. Entrust our elected leaders with strength, wisdom, and a discerning spirit, so that both our words and our actions serve you. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of hope, thank you for your constant presence as you walk with your children through challenges of joblessness, homelessness, grief, and sickness. Gather your community around all who need your healing power, that they find strength in you, especially Gary, Bob, Steve, Marjorie, Dale and Connie, Cindy, Ted, John and Sally, Jean, Roberta, Julie, Marlon, Jeff, Isla, Ron, Emily, Denise. We also pray for families and friends of our Savior's Lutheran Church. Phyllis, Jennifer, Mike, Kelly, Patty, Jasmine, Jerlyn, Gil, Bruce, Elijah, Ava, and Devold, and all those we name in our hearts before you. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of persistence, we glory in the gifts of our church leaders. Bless and strengthen our council members, staff, pastors, deacons, worship leaders, and all those who offer their gifts to this community, that our work together would serve your mission. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of unconditional love, sustain our outreach to neighbors as we share the love you have so generously given to us. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Living God, we give thanks for the whole communion of saints, each called in their own time to serve you, especially Henry, Bishop of Eusebia. Inspire our lives with their testimony. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. So we place our prayers before you, God, united in your spirit, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with
you. Let's share that peace.
please stand. Let us pray. God of wonder, you formed us in our mother's womb, and from the mother earth you bring forth this bread and wine. We place them on your table together with our lives and all that you have made. Open the heavens to us and pour out your spirit. We wait for your mercy. We long for your peace. We hunger and thirst for Jesus Christ, our banquet of life. Amen.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior, Jesus Christ. By the leading of a star, he was shown forth to all nations. In the waters of the Jordan, you proclaimed him your beloved Son. And in the miracle of water turned to wine, he revealed your glory. And so with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. The end, the giver of life. Blessed are you for the birth of creation. Blessed are you in the darkness and in the light. Blessed are you for your promise to your people. And blessed are you in the prophet's hopes and dreams. Blessed are you for Mary's openness to your will. Blessed are you for your Son, Jesus, the Word made flesh. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is a new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sins. Do this for the remembrance of me." Let us proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. With this bread and cup, we remember your word dwelling among us, full of grace and truth. We remember our new birth in his death and resurrection. We look with hope for his coming. Holy God, we long for your spirit. Come among us. Bless this meal. May your word take flesh in us. Awaken your people. Fill us with your light. Bring the gift of peace on earth. Come, Holy Spirit. All praise and glory are yours, Holy One of Israel, Word of God incarnate, power of the Most High, one God, now and forever. Amen. Amen. Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus has taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. A quick note about communion here at Our Savior's. You'll receive the wafer in your hand. Hold on to that. And when you come to a cup, there are two compartments. One has grape juice and the other has wine. Simply dip your wafer into which one you prefer, and then you end up taking the wine and wafer together at the same time. We call that intinction. Also, we want you to know that we honor your family's pattern for taking communion. The table is set and all are welcome. Please be seated.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Faithful God, you have kept your promise to us in this meal. Nourish us with the gift of salvation. Now send your servants forth in peace, that we may testify to your goodness and share the hope that is ours in Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Amen.
May Christ, the wisdom and power of God, and the source of our life together, keep you united in mind and purpose. And the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, be with you always. Amen.
Go in peace to grow, share, love, and inspire. Thank you.